And we have received quite a few questions about what you should do if you receive a stimulus check for a dead relative. Tonight we have answers. News 4 investigator Chris Negus has been tracking this issue since last month. He's live tonight sharing what he's learned. Chris?
Well, Steve, over the past couple of weeks, I've heard from a lot of viewers. They say they're going out to their mailbox and they're finding stimulus checks for relatives that died this year, 2019, even 2018. And over the past couple of weeks, there's not been a real clear answer from the IRS about what to do with those checks. But tonight, the answer is clear. You have to give the money back.
I got two stimulus deposits this week.
Veronica Jacobs is one of the first people I heard from. In mid-April, she received a stimulus check for her deceased mother, Audrey, and it led to an obvious question.
What do I do with it? What do I do with mom's $1,200? Do I send it back? I tried to contact the IRS, of course, got a recording, and so that was absolutely no help.
Lawmakers like Senator Josh Hawley weighed in.
I mean, if it's going to people who aren't alive, then it's a mistake and shouldn't flow.
But there was no official guidance from the IRS until today. The agency now says if someone died prior to receipt of payment, the money should be returned to the IRS. In some cases, it's complicated because Carrie of North County got a combined check of $2,400, one for her and one for her deceased husband, Edward. She says her tax preparer gave her advice that now contradicts that of the IRS.
And she had researched it and she taught me to keep it.
In cases like Carrie's, the IRS says $1,200 needs to be returned. If it's a paper check, they want you to write void on back and drop it in the mail. If it was a direct deposit, they want you to submit a personal check or money order. And it's going to lead to issues because some people have already spent it based on advice they were given. How is that money going to help you at this point?
And one thing, it helped me to pay my mortgage payment this month.
And I've also asked the IRS what will happen if people don't return those checks. They have not provided an answer to that question. And adding a little bit more confusion to this, if you're going to be sending a check back, well, if you live in the state of Illinois, you have to send it to an address in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. If you live in the state of Missouri, you have to send it to an address in Kansas City. I have provided that information, those addresses, on my Twitter account as well as my KMOV Facebook page if you happen to need that information. Reporting live in St. Louis County, Chris Negus, News 4 Investigate.